Essentially, since I was a little boy, I was raised a Christian. I was not only a Christian, I was very religious in my teenage years, preaching God to my friends. Heck, I even skipped my last class of the day in school along with my other friends, and we had our own Bible class. I was the teacher, the mentor to all of these kids. It disappointed me that my mother didn't let me go to a private school for my religion. It didn't bite though. By the age of 18, I graduated from high school. My brother couldn't see my graduation because he was at school for the moment. My mom wasn't there either. She went to see his elementary graduation. I was disappointed at her then too. Oh well, I shrugged and moved along. I figured she might watch the graduation video at home. I waved and smiled to make people more proud. In my speech, I read several, if not too many, Bible verses. Hey, I embarrassed myself enough after I read about 20 verses out of the book of John. That night, I went home. It felt so nice being out of school. My final year was complete. My mother was home, talking to Mark, my brother. They were talking about Mark going to a private school next year. My brother seemed a little disappointed he wouldn't get to see his friends again. But my mother convinced him, saying God is before friends. My jaw dropped. It wasn't fair. I didn't get to go to a private school. I was so jealous of Mark. But in a good way. I was proud of him. Happy for him. I got him ready for next year, and it hasn't even been a day into summer vacation. I was smiling and talking to him in his room all night. When I was digging in my closet for school stuff for Mark, I came to notice a really old Bible in the back, buried deep. After that, before I went to bed and after I showered, I read the Bible I found. The first page said, first published in year 0000, lastly published in 1982. I flipped to the next page that listed all of the Gospels on it. But something was up with it. It included the lost Gnostic Gospels. And I've read those too. But I never seen the usual Gospels and the Gnostic ones in the same Bible at the same time. But there was one more Gospel that I didn't recognize. It was called the Gospel of Gok. I turned it to that Gospel. Suspiciously, strangely enough, it had my name in it. My mother's name. My brother's name. In fact, everyone's name that I knew in real life, that I've ever met and knew well and see them at least occasionally, was in that gospel. It filled about 12 pages. Small font. And there were dates listed next to all of their names. I realized that the first dates were their birth year. And the second date must have been their death. How would the publishers even know my name or my birth or my friends and family members' names? Was it a weird coincidence? No, it couldn't be. I flipped through all of the pages, and I noticed some were in a red-colored font. The red-colored ones were the ones who I knew that already died. I didn't want to see anyone's death day, so I ignored that second date on all of them. But, on the last page I saw a gospel quote that said, "Oh, then kill the words which make one jealous. Kill those mouths which begat these words. Hang them to a tree with barbed wire. Gok 1:1. This has to be faked. The Bible wouldn't demand death, would it?" There was another page, which was strange because I could recall this being the last page. But I guess I just didn't notice it. I turned over the page and read the Gospel's word. "'Tis not the Holy Bible whom makes such demands. Though he does. Do this now or thou shall burn forever." Gok 1:1-2. It had to be a message from God. It was too coincidental to be true. But the only person who made me jealous was my mother. He wants me to kill my mother. I prayed a bit to the Lord, asking him to allow my mother to live. I heard my mother from downstairs say, "Gabriel, why are you still up? I know there is no school tomorrow, but you still have to go to bed." Quote, "Sorry, Mama," I said. I prayed again then went to sleep. In my dream, a man with a messed up face was stalking me for hours. I finally shouted, "What?" Quote, "Then, I saw his face, his horribly messed up face. It reminded me of something, the man said, in the deepest and most unrealistic voice ever. Kill thy mother, or thou shalt forever burn. Quote, who are you? I asked. I am, he announced in the same voice, and almost cut my sentence off with such a quick reply. I woke up a second later. All of the lights were off. Everyone was asleep. I noticed a sharp pain in my forehead. I reached and there was a small note stapled to my forehead. It was more painful as I noticed it. I tried ripping it out, leaving me a small scream in pain and agony. I read the note as I held the cut. It was a gospel. Give eth thy mother death, for then shall we be set. God 1, 1 to 1. It couldn't have been a coincidence. Now I knew. All of this was really a message from God. God was telling me to murder my mother. So I went in her room. She was sound asleep. I almost cried. I'd never see her awake again. Never again. I stabbed her with a kitchen knife. And she died quickly. She didn't have to die in pain. I fell on the ground crying. Please God, take care of her, I shouted to the heavens, waking my brother up. I looked at the note, noticing it had more words on it now. When thy brother enters, take that knife to his face. God 1, 1 to 2, why, God, why, I cried in a shout. I quickly took the knife out of my mother's chest, blood gushing everywhere, those little footsteps tapping to the room. As soon as he entered, he asked, Hugh, his little, sweet voice took over me. No, I thought, it was just a trick. My brother is Satan. He's making me believe he's cute and innocent. But he truly will be the Antichrist. I stabbed him in his cute and innocent face. I nearly burst into tears, but I had to keep going. More names popped into my mind. I must have killed half of my neighborhood within an hour. I fell on the road, puking. Why did God put me up for this job? I always wanted to be a Bible hero like Noah and Jesus and Moses. But I just realized how hard and horrible it truly was to be one. I cried as I went after my next victim. I broke into his house, killed him. By the morning, nobody was outside besides me, sleeping in the middle of the road. Everyone was dead, all of the cops. This town was a ghost town now. I woke up to find another message from God lodged into the road. The town hath been filled with the unholy spirit of Satan. There exists one more who shall die, and thou shalt become aware of him eventually. God 1, 1 to 3. Finally, only one more. I pushed myself up. I checked my Bible. Everyone was in red font, meaning they are dead. There wasn't another person on there except for me.